Everyone ready? Hey, good morning. Thank you very much for being here today. I am Lieutenant Steve Dijon with the Sheriff's Homicide Bureau. We are here today to ask the public's help regarding the murder of 40-year-old Irene Gonzalez. Before I begin, I would like to acknowledge several people here with us today. From Homicide Bureau, we have Acting Captain Art Spencer, our lead investigators in the case, Detectives Adam Kirstie and Nina Gonzalez. From Sentry Station, we have Captain Christopher Minot. And most importantly, we have Irene Gonzalez's family and friends. We have her mother, Maria Gonzalez, Irene's sons, Jesse Gonzalez and Jade, her cousin, Christina Cuevara, two of Irene's close friends, Stephanie Sam and Gladys Rodriguez. I would like to offer a sincere thank you to Supervisor Janice Hahn, along with the entire Board of Supervisors for the County of Los Angeles, for their approval of a $20,000 reward for information leading to the arrest and conviction of the persons responsible for the murder of Irene Gonzalez. The details of Irene's murder are as follows. On September 15th, 2024, at approximately 5:43 in the morning, deputies from Los Angeles County Sheriff's Department's Sentry Station responded to a gunshot victim call for service at the 12500 block of Oak Street in the city of Lynwood. Upon arrival, deputies observed Irene laying on the sidewalk, suffering from a gunshot wound to the upper torso. Tragically, Irene had succumbed to her injuries and died at the scene hours earlier. The reason why I said that Irene died hours earlier is Irene was discovered by a citizen of Lynwood at 5:43 in the morning who had been out for a morning walk. During our investigation, we discovered Irene was shot at 1:55 in the morning as she exited a black Toyota Corolla. A photograph of the actual vehicle is displayed on the bulletin behind me. We know that Irene was in the vehicle as it traveled on Long Beach Boulevard, traveled westbound on Euclid Avenue to northbound on Oak Street, where the vehicle came to a stop mid-block. Irene can be seen exiting the vehicle. As she exits the vehicle, she is shot by the driver. She stumbled toward the sidewalk and collapsed. Since it was 1:55 in the morning, most of the residents in the area were asleep. Some were awoken by the sound of a gunshot, while others believed it was fireworks. Unfortunately, no one called the Sheriff's Department to report what they heard. Irene was left where she collapsed all alone at 1:55 in the morning. She took her last breath and tragically died at the scene. Investigators have obtained video footage of the suspect's vehicle from the night of Irene's murder. If I can draw your attention again to the bulletin with the photographs of the Toyota Corollas, we need the public's help identifying the suspect's vehicle. We are looking for a 2014 to 2018 Toyota Corolla, black in color. The vehicle is a four-door sedan with a sunroof. Not every Toyota Corolla came with a sunroof. It was an optional item for this vehicle, so we ask the public focus on that detail. If anyone knows of the vehicle that matches the description, please call us. Focusing your attention on the driver's side front fender of our photograph of the suspect vehicle, there is a red, green, and yellow orb or reflection seen on the photograph of the fender. Those reflections are caused by the security camera of which we obtained the footage. Those are not reflectors or lights on the vehicle. The fender is solid black. On the same bulletin, we have provided a stock photograph of a similar Toyota Corolla. It is not the actual vehicle. This is to aid the viewer in identifying the make, model, and type of vehicle we are seeking to identify. As I stated, we are looking for a 2014 to 2018 Toyota Corolla, black in color, with four doors and a sunroof. If I can now focus your attention on the bulletin with the photograph of Irene. Investigators learned Irene Gonzalez was a mother who cared deeply for her two sons and was known to always put her sons before herself. Irene had a close relationship with a few friends and cousins who she viewed as her sisters. Irene leaves behind her mother, Maria Gonzalez, her two sons, Jesse Gonzalez and Jaden, her sister, Maggie Chaidez, two brothers, Joe Mandahano and Sergio Gonzalez. Irene's family described her as a caring soul, always putting her sons and others before herself. She was known to give those to those in need before focusing on her own needs. Irene found joy helping others by being a loyal friend and sister. The Los Angeles County Sheriff's Department's Homicide Bureau and Irene's family are asking for the public's help in identifying her killer and the Toyota Corolla used in her murder. Irene did not deserve to die in the manner that she did. We are asking for the public's assistance and hope that people will have the courage to come forward and help investigators identify the vehicle and or persons responsible for this senseless and violent act, so we can bring some semblance of closure to the family. Anyone with information is urged to contact detectives from Los Angeles County Sheriff's Homicide Bureau at 323-890-5500. For those who have information and wish to remain anonymous, you can call Crime Stoppers at 1-800-222-8477. At this time, I believe we are going to have Irene Gonzalez, the mother, Maria Gonzalez, speak.
Does she still want to speak? Would you like to?
Buenas tardes, gracias a todos por su ayuda. Yo soy la mamá de Irene Gonzalez. Pido la ayuda de toda la gente, de toda la comunidad, que se compadezcan, por favor, que nos ayuden para poder localizar a ese animal que le quitó la vida a mi hija tan cruelmente. Ella tiene sus hijos, son niños especiales que la necesitan. Fue buena madre, buena hija, buena hermana. No merecía morir de esa forma. Por favor, ayúdenme, por favor, a difundir toda la información que se pueda. Quien sepa, véanse en esta madre. Eviten que a sus hijas les pase lo mismo con una persona tan cruel y tan mala. Por favor, es el clamor de una madre que está sufriendo por la pérdida de su hija. Le agradezco a los medios de comunicación, a la policía, a todos los que están haciendo todo por ayudarnos, con la recompensa, con toda la información. Ninguna madre, ningunos hijos merecen quedarse huérfanos por la crueldad de una persona tan mala. Mis nietos la necesitan. Ya no hay vuelta atrás. No me resigno, pero ya acaté la voluntad de Dios, pero ellos no lo entienden, mis nietos no lo entienden. ¿Qué le vas a decir? Tú, que asesinaste a mi hija, da la cara, entrégate. Van a dar contigo. Tienes que estar en la cárcel por el resto de tu vida. Vas a pagar por lo que hiciste. Ayúdenme. Como madres que son, los padres, hermanos, todos vamos a colaborar, por favor. Muchas gracias.
As Maria stated, please help us. Please help us identifying Irene's killer and the vehicle that was involved in her murder. I would like to thank all the news agencies. I will now take questions to try to answer those that I can without jeopardizing the active investigation. I know we don't have a lot of reporters here, but we have cameramen. Do you guys have any questions whatsoever?
How do you deal with the fact that people don't ever want to come forward with information? I know $20,000 is what you're trying to lure them in, but it seems like people are reluctant to say anything.
Well, I would hope people have the courage because they can remain anonymous. They don't necessarily have to come forward and give their identity. As we noticed in recent events in the news, that the reason why that shooter in New York was caught because people decided to make a phone call and call. So that's all we ask, is even if you are not interested in the reward, but you know what occurred, you know what happened to Irene, you can always remain anonymous by calling Crime Stoppers.
Was there any license plate, any portion of the license plate that was captured on the photo or video?
No, there was not. The only thing we were releasing right now is a picture of the vehicle. That's what we need help identifying. Any questions? Okay. I would like to thank all the news agencies for being here today. Please help us get the word out to the public. We are asking for their assistance, your assistance. We hope people that have the courage to come forward and help my investigators solve Irene's senseless murder so we can bring some semblance of closure to the family. Thank you very much.